Good morning, class 12. Today in this video you are going to learn how to calculate national income by value added method. My children, already in my previous video I have explained you that how national income is measured in terms of value addition by each producing enterprise during a particular year, where value added is actually a difference between value of output of an enterprise and the value of intermediate consumption. Now, to do these numericals, you need to thoroughly study that under value added method, what are the items to be included and what are to be deducted, and which is possible only when you all have gone through the equation thoroughly. Already I have explained you that the procedure of value-added method is that once you add all the values of the different sectors and you get a GDP at market price, and from that GDP at market price, when you deduct depreciation, then you get at NDP at market price, and from that NDP at market price, you need to deduct the net indirect tax. Once you deduct the net indirect tax, you are able to get the net domestic product at factor cost, in which when you add NFIA, net factor income from abroad, you get NNP at factor cost, which is national income. So children, kindly go through it very nicely, thoroughly, so that you are able to do the numericals. So let's start with the first numerical over here of national income, and the data which has been given over here is, it has been said that from the following data you are supposed to calculate gross value added at market price and national income, and the data is, one side you have items, other side you have rupees in lakh, and the items which have been given are, the first is value of output of primary sector, which is 800, secondary sector, which is 200, tertiary sector, which is 300. Second is value of intermediate input purchased by primary sector is 400, secondary sector is 100 lakh, and tertiary sector is 50 lakh. Third is indirect taxes paid by all sectors, which is 50. Fourth is consumption of fixed capital of all the sectors, which is actually a depreciation. I told you before also that consumption of fixed capital is depreciation, which is 80 lakh. Then fifth is factor income received by the resident from rest of the world, means this is NFIA, which is 10 lakh. Then sixth is factor income paid to non-resident, means the income which is going out of a country is 20 lakh. And seventh item is subsidies received by all sectors is 20 lakh. So now what we'll do, we'll find out the very first thing, that is the gross value added at market price. So children, you know very well, to find out gross value at market price, you need to add the value of output of all the sectors, and from that you need to deduct the value of intermediate consumption. So let's start. So the value of output of primary sector is 800 plus value of secondary sector 200 plus value of tertiary sector 300. Now from this, let's minus the value of intermediate input of primary sector 400 minus the value of intermediate input of secondary sector 100 and minus the value of intermediate input of tertiary sector as 50, and you get rupees 750 lakh, which is your gross value added at market price, right? Now the next thing which we have to find out is national income. Now children, to find out the national income, you know very well that you have a GDP at market price with you, that is 750 lakh. So what we'll do, from this 750 lakh, we are going to deduct the depreciation, the value of depreciation, that is consumption of fixed capital, which is rupees 80 lakh. And once you deduct the depreciation, now children, you get the NDP at market price. So now, once you get NDP at market price, now what you are supposed to do from this, you are going to deduct the net indirect tax. That means you will minus the indirect tax, which is 50, and you will add the subsidies, which is 20. once you add it, then you are able to get NDP at factor cost. Now in this NDP at factor cost, what you will be doing it, you are going to add the value of NFIA, net factor income from abroad, which is rupees 10 lakh, and deduct the value of factor income which is paid to non-resident, which is 20 lakh, right? So let's put the value, and we are putting the value, that is our GDP at market price is 750. In 750 minus depreciation, you get 670, which is NDP at market price. Then in 670, what you will be doing is, you are going to minus the indirect tax, which is 50. You get 620 plus the subsidies, which is 20. You get 640, which is your NDP at factor cost. And now from NDP at factor cost, what you will be doing it? You are going to add the value, that is the value of NFIA, factor income received by the resident from rest of the world, which is 10 lakh, which comes to 650. And now you are going to deduct the value of factor income paid to the non-resident, which is 20 lakh. And you get your NNP at factor cost or national income to be as rupees 630 lakh. So children, this is how you are able to find out national income, right? Now let's do one more numerical. And over here, this time we need to find out the net value added at factor cost from the following data. Okay, so the data which has been given over here is, the items first is purchase of machinery to be used in the production unit. Now this is how much? This is 100. Then second is sales, which is 200. Then we have the intermediate cost. Intermediate cost is of rupees 90. Then we have indirect tax. Now when we talk about indirect taxes, we have, it is 12. Then we have change in stock, which is 10. Change in stock, you know very well, that is closing stock minus opening stock, right? Then we have excise duty, which is 6. Then we have stock of raw material, which is 5 crores, right? Now children, what we are supposed to do is, we are supposed to find out the net value added at factor cost. Now to find out the net value added factor cost, before that you need to find out what? You need to find out the gross value added at market price. That means we need to find out first gross value. And you know very well, already I have explained you before also, that to find out, what you are supposed to do is that you need to take the sales plus change in stock, right? That means value of output is measured as sales plus change in stock, where you have your sales to be as 200 crore. In this 200 crores, you are going to do what? You will add the change in stock, which is 10, and you are going to minus the intermediate consumption. So your intermediate cost is how much? It is 90 crore. So when you add change in stock, that is 10 crore with the sales, and you deduct intermediate consumption, that is 90 crores, you get your gross value added at market price to be as rupees 120 crores, right? Now it becomes very easy to come at net value added at factor cost. The simple thing which you have to do is that from this gross value added market price, you are going to deduct the value of indirect taxes, right? That means your gross value added is rupees 120 crore, and from this 120 crore, deduct the value of indirect taxes, which is 12 crore. And you get your net value added factor cost as rupees 108 crores. Right? The only thing which you have to remember is that where which item has to be added and where which item has to be deducted. It is net value. Understood? You have to deduct the taxes. So we have deducted the taxes from the GDP at market price and we got our net value added at factor cost, which is rupees 108 crore. So children, this is how you can calculate net value added factor cost from the given data by value added method. Good morning.